Hi guys, welcome to my illustration blog. I've only recently started to use Adobe Fresco and I love the fact that it has got a masking feature just like in Adobe Photoshop. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to use layer masks on Adobe Fresco on your iPad. Let's go! Hey guys, today I'm going to be showing you how to use layer masks in Adobe Fresco. I'm going to show you why it can be useful. Let's say that we created a shape, but we want to edit it. One way of editing this shape or erasing parts of it that we don't need would be to use an eraser, where you would literally erase parts of the image that you don't want or don't like. But the problem with this method is that once you've erased something, you can't bring it back. If you instead use a mask, you will be able to erase parts of this image and then bring them back in if you need to. Let me show you how. If you click on the layer in Fresco and then you select Create Empty Mask, you will see now that on the layer you can swipe between the image and this white square. This white square is a layer mask. At the moment there is nothing masked on this layer. This is why we see the whole drawing. And you see at the bottom that you have reveal and hide options. So let's say that I want to hide part of these images. We make sure that we are on this white square, which is a mask, not on the image layer. And then we choose hide. Then you simply select any brush that you like. For example, a basic brush. And you erase parts of the layer that you don't like. Let's make a star shape. Okay, this is good. And you can see that what I end up with is the star shape. But you can also see that, say I have some imperfections which I would like to fix. If I didn't have a mask, I would have to go to the same brush I used and then use the color tool and color these parts in. But because I have a mask, I can easily fix it just by revealing parts of the mask that I've hidden. So we make sure that it says reveal, we select a brush, and then you can just edit the mask and you will see that all your pixels are still there and you are basically revealing them. So you can spend your time and get your image exactly the way that you want. So if you switch back to the layer, you see that you have a layer that you can still edit and drag and do anything you want with it. But if you ever want to change it, you just need to go to the mask and either hide or reveal parts of the layer. As you can see, the original drawing is still there if you need to go back to it. And now that I've shown you what the mask is, I want to show you how else you can use masks for your illustration. So let's say that you drew a shape and you just want to mask this particular shape. In this case, you go to layer, but instead of pressing create empty mask, you press mask layer contents. And now you see that the mask is automatically created around this shape that you made. And now, if you want to draw on top of this shape, it's going to be very useful because anything you draw is not going to go outside the edges of the mask. It's particularly useful if you want to add textures or effects. And another super cool tip that I have discovered for my own work and I'm just going to share with you is that you can add as many textures as you like, but also you can edit these layers in the future or delete them if you don't like them. And to do that, you copy a layer mask from one layer. So we go back to this layer and we press copy mask. And then we make a new layer and we paste a mask. It will still only cover the same area as the layer underneath, but the benefit of using another layer with another mask is that you can then, for example, use blending modes to create some really interesting effects. Guys, if you found this video useful, then please give it a thumbs up, please subscribe to my channel. I create new videos every week, and let me know in comments if there's anything else that you would like to learn about fresco or illustration in general. Thank you for watching and see you soon.